on the back. Okay. Okay, good. So, okay. So, my talk today is about the dependency injection. And I want to introduce about me first. I'm Michael Bui. I started working with PHP a very long time ago and officially working for a company since 2008. I like programming, I like learning new things, and I like building things. I also like photography, chess, traveling, trekking, sports. I like futsal every week. And if anyone want to join us, you are welcome. And I'm the father of a lot of daughter. Okay. So today is workshop, and I prepare one like exercise for us for today. So if you go to our phpcoms.asia website, we can see the list of speakers, right? So our task today is like we try to pass the website and get the list of the speaker from that. It's very simple task only. Yeah. So this is a tool we will use to help us on this one. And before going to the workshop, I expected everybody to get our hands dirty, try to write some code, try to run it, and to see the result, and you can feel. So let me go through the website first. So this is the PHP Conference Asia website, and I want to get on the speaker. If you go to the speaker tab here, you will be scrolled down to the this section. And what I want is I get all of this name, even further down, like this. And I want to sort it by alphabetical orders. So, okay, let's assume we can anybody can see it clearly or on the screen? Okay, so imagine this is interface of our class. I want to have a conference type classes. We have one method called list speaker. And this list speaker will return an array of speaker names. Okay, so anybody have questions so far? Okay, good. We are good to go. The first thing, I prepare the GIS. So this is a basic code for us to start. And I will share this link on our event page. It's here. So you guys just go to our Facebook and click on this link. You will get a list of the code. So do you have a composer installed on your machine already? Okay. So if you don't, you just go get composer.org. And this is how you install composer on your machine. So I give you some time to install Composer. And if you have any difficulty to install it, you find any issue or problem, feel free to let me know. I will come to help. Okay. Yes.
Because I'm on a new Windows machine.
Yeah.
Can you help me get the PHP set up in the Docker?
You don't really need Docker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because I...
Yeah, you just install PHP as usual normal, because this one is very simple one.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That means I go into my...
Yeah.
That means as a Windows native.
Yes. PHP. If they have. I'm not sure if PHP Windows 10 have it.
Okay, this Windows 10. Yeah.
I'm not sure.
He told us to download the Docker, so I thought it's easier that
Okay.
to do it inside Docker.
Okay, I never tried in Windows 10.
Yeah.
Okay, but the link is getcomposer.com, not .com.
Okay.
Yeah. Also prepare your folder structure like this, workshop folder, and so we same align and we can start easily. Okay, okay, okay. So yes. Composer.file you can put anywhere where you can access.
Oh.
Yeah. Anywhere on your local system. Yeah. But usually you can put it the same folder with composer.json. Yeah. You can use it. Okay. Give me a minute. Yes.
His website, he has this link, download and run composer setup.
Yeah.
Mine don't have same.
No, because this is Mac, this window.
Then how do I...
okay, you copy it like this.
I copy?
Yeah. You follow this one, yeah. And copy and run in your terminal.
Run in where?
Terminal. Yeah. You, yeah.
Like that?
Yeah. Okay, give some time to download. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Just click next. Next. PHP version here, right? Okay. Okay, it's installing. See, finished already. Where is your ID? The IDE. I'm not sure which IDE are you using. Yeah. Can you have him to install the composers? I think. Yeah. So anyone? Okay.
After having composer, I just go to this. So I downloaded a folder. And yeah. I just composer install in that folder. That's it.
Yes.
Because yeah. I see you still have a few more other folders there. So.
Can you see my folder structure?
Actually, a bit small, but like nice. So I think.
Okay. I don't know how to zoom it in, but let me try.
It's okay.
Okay, give me a second. Sorry, I cannot zoom out. Yeah. Yes? Sorry? No, you don't need for my talk. Maybe I'm not sure for the other, but for my talk, you don't need to install. Just run in the native PHP, it's okay.
And what about the Wi-Fi connection?
I'm not sure you asked.
Michael.
Yeah.
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Any particular PHP version?
Sorry?
Any particular PHP version?
Currently, I tested in PHP 5.5, so any above 5.5 should be okay. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry. Hi. JSON extension because, okay, so when you install PHP, you didn't install the JSON extension. So try.
So, because I can I use XAMPP to do the PHP, or I have to install PHP right into my.
I think you can use XAMPP. XAMPP will have PHP, but then you have to find where is the PHP runtime files.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then I can install this composer.
Yes, I think because here you can. Here you are using Sigfrin, right?
Okay.
So that's why they cannot find any version. So if you install XAMPP, and I think it should be able to find it.
But it would be easier if I'll just install PHP right in my PC and then do the gecko post.
Yeah, but I think since you are already installed Sigfrin, you can just install the PHP JSON.
Okay.
Yeah.
Since it's installed in my Sigfrin, so
yes.
I'll just have to install the JSON.
Yes, just search for Sigfrin PHP JSON installation on Google. Yeah.
Windows 7?
Yet it should be able to run in Windows 7 as well.
Okay.
But I'm not sure, maybe you do you have permission to install? Okay.
Installed already, and then at the end, the last steps, right, it tells me to restart command prompt. Then I have to log in and log out, but I'm not sure what it's referring to.
Okay, let's see what happened. Let's see if have composer installed. So you guys can see the folder structure better now? Yeah. This plus mean anything above this. Yeah. Just only on Facebook event, so everybody can check it out. Okay.
Getting this message.
Let's see the packagation. I can never. Okay, because in PHP configuration, this function is disabled.
Okay. I need to know where is my PHP ini.
Yes.
Roughly know where is it?
Yes, you can. Okay, let me try for you. Usually you can just PHP that I for info and you graph dot ini. Here it should be in the first here. This is a
Okay.
Sorry.
I actually have the composer.log file. It's fine, right?
Yes. After you, where do you install the composer.log file?
I don't have. I just download the only has three files.
Okay. You have a structure, right? And then you download the composer.
Yeah.
Getcomposer.org.
I got it.
Okay. Where is that? Okay, do you know where this look? Let me see.
That's a shortcut.
So, okay, this is right. Okay, so composer. Okay, we have here. It's have execution. So, okay. So, where is this?
It's in projects, in desktop projects.
Let's start project one. Okay, good. So, CD.
So, this is actually a shortcut. You don't actually
use it. Start. Project.
Yes.
Okay. And.
This folder is workshop.
Oh, okay. Okay, then you can run. Okay, let me check if I should have. Okay, PP and composer alpha install. Now it's been passed the composer.json file, and once it's download the version, it will get the .log file. The .log file is log the version to its packages.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's more convenient for you to download in the next time. Okay, welcome. So whoever downloaded and have Composer installed can run this command, and you can change this path to your local path to composer.file. So after you run this command to install all the dependencies for our projects, and this command will generate the composer.log file here. So you don't have to worry about composer.log for now. So just run it, and it will pass the composer.json file and download on the packet we define in the composer.json. So this is a command. Because I put in the many on the parents folder. Yeah. You can change this to your local part. Yeah. I think by default it will be inside your user folder. If you download the composer file.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we can't really see what's going on. So basically, we have already put in the downloaded Git source, and then we have also installed a composer.
Yeah.
So what's the next thing that we
do? Okay, you need to follow the folder structure. Give me a second first. I think it's okay. You can run like this. Where is your composer? Okay, I think composer is inside here. Okay, your local folder. So where is your project folder?
My project folder is in my Xam folder.
Okay.
Oh, I have to actually run it in my project
yes,
folder.
Yes, correct.
I see.
So I think if I can copy this part.
You can press the copy.
Okay, so you can run pp composer file install, because it's already have a composer position here. We will change this structure later.
Okay,
but just run it. Oh, you don't have it. And you need to install first.
Okay.
Give it some time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
after it's installed Git, and it can run the composers.
Okay.
Yeah. Or if not running, you can just rerun the command.
Okay.
Yeah.
Still tell me that I have this JSON extension.
How did you install the PHP JSON?
I check on the GitHub version, and then it's actually installed already with Zap.
Oh no, this is in the Zap. This is Zam, but this one is a Cygwin.
Oh, yes.
They are two different things.
Okay.
Yeah. So, like for example, p dash I get JSON. So you see, you don't have any JSON library installed.
Okay.
Yeah. So you need to install for Cygwin, not for Zam. So okay. Forget Zam for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll install.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I inside the my directory, which is over here. Yeah. I just run this composer.
Yes. Correct.
Right. It
says. But this part. Where is your composer file? Yeah. That's one. Okay. It's a difference between Mac and Windows.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically, you just copy this. How to copy here? Okay.
Just type the URL then install.
I think it's copy. Okay. Pp. Okay. Install. So this is a path, your local path to composer. Okay, it's running fine now. Yep.
We went to the directory, but we cannot install composer file because we don't have the composer JSON file. So where can we get the composer.json file?
Oh, okay. Let me check where. How do you install PHP?
PHP?
Yeah.
I think just now when I tried to download the composer ESC file, it asked me to install PHP.
So okay, where is your composer.json file?
It's in this directory.
Ooh. No, this is different. Okay. Sorry. Can you see? I have a composer.json file here.
Oh, you have to type exactly the directory, is it?
Okay.
The slashes and the dots.
No. But where
it's
is your?
Over here. Where is the composer?
I went to this directory.
Bin.
No, this one don't have a composer.json. You need to generate the composer.json if you go. You have a Facebook here?
Facebook.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, we get the composer JSON file from the.
Yes, I set the link here. Team can see, I think so. Or maybe you try login first. Have you tried installing this?
pp-json?
No. Okay, you don't have appsys. So...
Yeah, it has the same problems.
Okay. I'm not sure if this is the solution or not. Okay. It means so sleep win. Where is your sixth win? Where you run the sixth win to install? This is fine already. But where do you extract this one? No, you already have it installed.
Yes.
But I want to see where is that folder.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. You extract the six-win folder here, right?
Yes.
I'm not sure. Okay, then you can try this one. Okay, just follow this one. You'll see. So you make the folder structure like this. For your PHP installation, you didn't install the OpenSSL extension is not installed.
How
did you install PHP?
Just now when I installed the Composer, I download the ESC file. I download, meanwhile the step it asked me whether to install PHP, I just click yes, that's all. I think it's not to my C drive, PHP. There's a PHP folder.
Because it's missing this one, so you cannot it. It's a long time I haven't tried in Windows, so sorry about this one.
Probably I just have to find out how to install SSL.
Yes, you should, right.
Okay, I'll try to do
yeah. No need to run all of this. You only need to run PHP JSON only. PHP and PHP file. Yeah. don't copy and paste like this. This is one command. So have you installed app 6? Okay, good. Install pp.json and let's try this. It's still downloading.
Okay.
Okay. So you prepare the folder structure like this. Put the call the interface file inside the folder. The conference interface file. Yeah, you put in this, follow this folder structure.
Instead of using my command line, I can use this sequence to run those scripts.
This one, if you install properly, then yes, you can just run it.
I can use this one too.
Yes. Okay. So basically, let me check pp.py. Try to grab JSON. Yes, now you have JSON support. So you can try to run the Composer install. It's a bit difficult to run from here. I think you can ask her. She also have a window. So first thing, you need to install Sigwin. This is a package here. I think can you help her or install the PHP? Not yet. So I think they need to download Sigwin. Have you installed the on the package, right?
Yeah.
Later when we everybody installed it, I will start. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Yes. JSON is not okay because where is your JSON composer.json file? You see, I have a composer JSON here, and
okay. I have in my www folder.
Okay, let me see. Okay, here. You have Yeah, you need to update this one first because it's outdated.
I just updated, not self-update, just composer update.
No, this is self-update, that means it's updated composer version.
Oh, okay,
so
okay.
When you run the composer update, you update the package version.
Okay.
Okay, so now you just can composer install.
Sorry, just a quick one. So I have to make it the same structure as the one?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, good. You are good to go. Everything is there. So basically, you make a folder structure like this.
Okay, I'll just...
Yes.
You need to make the folder structure like this.
Yeah. Sorry? No, the vendor is here. Yeah, the vendor is a composer folder.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, so you don't have to touch it.
Mm-hmm.
You just put the conference.interface inside the folder.
Inside the, okay.
Yeah. Been setting up. Yeah, okay. What is the error you see?
This one is looking for an icon or an
extension. Icon V extension, okay. Very simple, you can just run like apt-sys install pp icon V and pp mb string. There you go.
It's all apt-sys and then install.
Yes. At some time. In order to run, you need to install all this VP. Okay, install. Good to go. Okay, now you can go next. Keep it sometime, okay. Give it some time to download all the packages. So if you need some, if you see any missing package, you just do a apt-sys install and pp hyphen the name of the package. Yes, you're welcome. Because you are running pp 5.4. All our package now is running pp 5.5 at least. Yeah, I don't know, but you have to use pp 5.5 at least. Yeah. Which first, which Mac version?
I'm using a Vagrant box actually.
Ah, okay. Then you use a better Vagrant.
No. This is my version.
which OS you are running? Ubuntu or what?
This one is Ubuntu, yeah.
Ubuntu, right? Okay. Which Ubuntu version? Let me check. Okay, so this is not Ubuntu. What is?
Oh, it's Yum install. So it's
okay. Yum. Yes. It's very good for Android. Why don't you just install Vitropia in your local?
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I think you can run it in your local here. Because from here, right? Wow, it's open like this.
All my work from my working in this closet.
Okay. Can I close this one as well?
Yes.
Okay. I see. Okay. So, your local is already being fine. You can create any folder. Yeah. You have Composer installed, right?
Yes.
So you can start.
Thanks to Jason here.
Yeah.
he you know, saved me.
Okay. So you try to figure out how to get the speaker from the website. Get list of speaker from the website.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll try.
Yeah. So, or you need to put the folder structure like this first. So let's. In the source and conference and go to conference interface. This file.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you do what with it?
No, I mean this one is thin in. I mean the folder structure, the conference interface should be inside the conference folder.
Okay.
And the conference folder inside the source folder.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you want to make a folder called source and one called conference?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just for you.
Yeah. Because this one later is have a some kind of like PP standard.
Okay.
Yeah. So one folder inside the soft folder will be a kind of like sub namespace.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Need to install the composer. Just go to the getcomposer.org. No. Website. Yeah, getcomposer.org.
Composer.
Yeah.
get composer. Okay, copy and paste this for lights, on four lights. On the, yeah.
On the four lights?
Yeah. Let me have it. Yeah. Okay. And just paste it. And the, give it some time to. Okay, it's downloading. Yeah. Guys, anyone is still have composer in store? Okay. Who hasn't installed composer successfully? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I think all from Windows, right?
Available here,
yeah.
But it gives me this error, so
I'm trying to figure out. Let me see.
Oh, can I just see? I think I
can install. Where is this extension deal?
Specify the directory.
Yeah, you need to specify the directory as well. They should have it, and it's just. See, extension deal doesn't have anything.
So I have to remove.
Yes.
Okay.
So basically, yes, you need to remove this one, and let's see.
What? And the coffee? Or just leave it?
Just leave it. Yeah, so far so good, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Still installing.
We have to re-download from the another mirror.
At 99%, there was an error message saying that something else. So
we have to re-download.
Okay.
If they cannot install, try again.
Because this computer is very weak. When it downloads too many, it may cause some conflict or some error. Yeah, so that's why this computer is too small for that. Usually this type of computer you're using for watching movie, browsing website, or writing some document, but it's not for programming.
Oh, maybe that's why.
Yeah. This is a mini computer rather than a real computer.
Ask how to get a Mac. No, kidding.
Yeah. Okay. No, really, if you want to do programming, you need to get a Mac. Highly recommend it. Because the terminal in Mac is much better.
Yeah.
And actually the Mac, you have a balance between the graphic interface and the terminal as well.
These both are quite strong.
Yes. Unix
In Linux, right, you don't have a graphic, the good graphic interface, but in Mac you have a boot. Yeah. Okay, sure. So, how is this? Okay. Great, great, great. Yeah, just finish. Okay, I think I... Can you open your terminal? Okay, let's see. It's not installed yet, so ask her how to install app 6.
App 6?
Yeah.
Is it really she found it? No, not this one.
No, not this one. AppSec is another one. Yeah, ask her. It should be a very simple command. Sorry?
Do I need Apache?
No, you don't need Apache.
Just Composer and PHP?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Actually, Composer is a PHP script.
Huh?
Composer is a PHP script.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically, you just install PHP.
But I install Composer. How can I, like, I mean, when I just click install, then I select the PHP part. But where is it located?
Okay, where you run the command for PHP install
composer? Oh, so it's where I run the command.
Where is the composer? Yeah. But I mean, where is the composer.file? I think. Hanif? Hanif, where is the composer.file in Windows?
C drive, app data, something.
It depends. One of them installed there, right? It's inside his user folder.
Okay.
Some odd reason. Yeah. So it really depends on where they run that command.
Okay. No, but the thing is, they run the application.
It's inside environment variables. It's in the environment variables somewhere.
It's in the file.
Let me try.
It's all in the hidden files, somewhere, like under your
thing. How
why
do
you want to go?
Why do you need to know where?
I need to run the Composer install.
I installed already. Yeah.
No, it should be in your path already. It should be in your path. You just type your Composer. It should be in your path. You will run the installer.
No.
Should I use PowerShell or Command?
It's actually printing out the help file.
You also have you have a 6-win as well, right?
Huh?
You install PHP by Xam, right?
No, I just stand alone. I tried to download the WAM, but the installer is corrupted. So I just stick to the PHP 7.
Okay.
Yeah. And then after I install the Docker, I find that my machine always hangs.
Fuck it.
Yeah.
Okay.
something wrong.
Yeah, I think it's...
Oh, okay, it's just slow.
Yeah, it's slow.
Okay, so where is your composer.json from?
Huh?
Have you created your composer.json file?
Haven't.
Okay, you go to our Facebook.
Actually, I can just listen and learn. I don't
want
to like need to
transfer. Okay.
Yeah.
You go to the our event page. I see the script. You just follow.
Oh, okay.
Click on events. Ah, here, right here. Happening now. Upsig from here.
This line.
Ah, okay. No, 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 not, not the, not. Okay, guys, it's time to start now. We take a very long time to install all the dependencies. So, okay, so this is the interface, and all the our library will base on this interface to get the data from the website. So. This is a website, and I want to get owner this name. So, anyone have suggestion how to get this name?
Yeah. You
do a file, put contents into a variable, and parse through a bunch of stuff?
Yes, but it's very complex to pass. For example, if you know jQuery, right? Usually I want to hack this website. Sorry, but I'm tied here to make sure that we have jQuery. Yeah, the dollar sign is very, very famous for jQuery library. So then I will try to see I think it's very difficult for people to see this one.
Yeah, impossible.
Yeah. Yeah. So okay. So basically when I try to inject the web page, I will see that the name inside the H4 tag cannot make a bigger font from here. Yeah. Yes. Good. Can you see it now? Can you see from the back? Okay, so basically this is a web inspector from Chrome. I think in Firefox we have a Firebug. In Safari, you have the same as well. It's also a Chrome web inspector. You click on this button, this tool, so you mouse over on the element. It will show you the structure. And from here, we can see that the structure, the name, is inside H4 tag. And H4 tag inside the offset L1 class. So I try to test to make sure that this selector will get all the name.
H4.
Yeah. So see?
Look at that. Okay.
So basically I find the class offset L1 and then inside the offset L1 I find the tag H4. And here we see a list of array here. So basically, maybe this is not fully correct, but we can have a concept that this one have the list of the speaker in our website. So if I get the name, it's printed all the name one by one together. So basically, we can see that by using jQuery, we can get this name easily. But we are using PHP. So how we do that? Yeah. So the first thing I will do, I will create a class, a concrete class, implement this interface. I call it PHP Asia 2016 version 1. This is version 1. Later, I will have another version to show you what is the difference between these two. So I implement the conference interface here, and you see this. Okay, I need to zoom it out. Can you see now? Okay, so you see they have a red underline. The red underline, when you mouse over, it will say that I implement the conference interface, but I didn't implement the list speaker method. So now I have to install the list. List speaker method. Okay, you see the red light is gone. So basically, once you implement an interface, all the methods inside the interface must be implemented inside the concrete garage. Okay. So our main function, our main code will be happening here. So by usually what we're doing now is we try to connect to the website, get the data, get the HTML data, and pass the HTML data to get the speaker names. Okay, that's what we do, right? So basically, I need to have a client to connect to the website. Okay, this first thing we need to connect to the website and get the content of the website. The client class is the utility class from Gazo package. The Gazo package is for HTTP clients to connect to make a request to any website. So once we get the data of the website, we need to pass it, right? And we have a tool called crawler. So we create a crawler and we put the response inside the crawler and we will use this one to find the name. So similar to jQuery, we will use the same selector from jQuery. So this is very convenient for us. I think jQuery is quite famous for, and we already get used to with jQuery. So the node will be a list of array as we see in the web page now, is in the web inspector here. Here's the list. Here is the node we have. So I need to go through the list of this node and extract the names. Okay, so for each note, on the text content of the note will be the name of the speaker. So I will put this on this name into the array names. And now another requirement is we sort it by alphabet, right? NatSort is a built-in function from PHP. So this one, I just use this one for demonstration only. So you don't care much how it works or what is this, but this is function to sort by sort alphabetically. And after sorting the names, we return it. Okay. Any questions so far? Are you sure this one will work? Okay. How to make sure that this one will work? Yes, we write a test for this now. So I create a folder and make sure that the folder in the test folder will be follow the structure in the source folder. This will be a mapping that we are when we test a class, when we have a test class, the test class is for a source class. So, so this is a test class. So all the namespace for test classes will start with test. And after that, it will be exactly like the source class. And on the test classes must end it by this suffix, the test suffix, this one. Make sure your class name must be exactly same like this. Otherwise, the PHP unit will not detect it. So in a PHP unit test, this setup method is running before every single test of this class. And one test will be prefixed by this name, test with a lowercase. If you don't have this test, for example, you want to write your name function name like this, you need to indicate it in the annotation called this test. So PHP unit, we know that this is a test. But for your convenience, we just use a prefix. And we set up an object of the class PHP Asia 2006 version 1. And what we test now is we try to get all the names by calling the method from the conference. Right. And here we see this guy, right? So I know that this guy must be inside the list. So I expect that this name is inside this array of names. So what we're doing now is we try to run the test to make sure this test is passed. So since we already use Composer install, so vendor is the Composer folder, and it's the bin is the binary file. PHP unit is a library from PHP unit package for you to run the test. And by default, this one will read the PHP unit.xml, which I provided before.
What is 15 composer install?
Okay, good. You see, after running the test, we see that all the test pass. We only have one test only. So the test pass means the name, this guy is inside our list. So again, in order to make sure that your application is running fine, you need to write the test, because the test is almost instant feedback for you to make sure that your application is running fine or not. If you need to deploy it in order to make sure that it's running, it takes very long, a lot of time to go back and forward. So come back to this. Now, our program is running fine. So like we can say the boss, I'm done. But it like how, okay. Anybody can see the problem from this code? Okay, just example. I close my Wi-Fi connection. So there's no internet connection to the website. And I try to run the test again. Boom, fail. Because it cannot connect, And when it cannot connect, there's the name array is empty. That means there's no, the guy is not inside the list. So that's why it didn't fail. But our program is running 5v4. And our program shouldn't depend on the internet connection, right? How we make sure that? The problem from the code is that when we run the test, we actually run a connection with another party. So in order to write the test, we try to avoid that one. And how to avoid that is by mocking the request. So we don't actually run the request, but we still return some data for us to run the test. Okay. But if you write the code like this, we cannot mock anything at all. Because when we call this method, everything inside this method will be run. And it's really our controls. There's no way for us to make change inside here. And here we come with the concept of dependency injection. As you can see inside the code, this code will depends on two dependencies. The first one is HTTP clients. The second one is a DOM crawler. So I will try to improve this one. Okay. So basically, I will leave this method here, but I will create a new class. The class is still implement the interface, and I still have implement that method, public function, guest speaker, I think so. Yes. No, what is this? List speaker, sorry. Okay. But from here, okay, what's your question? Can you speak louder? Which file? Okay. This test file, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry?
I can modify this. Okay.
You want to modify this?
No, I can just copy this one first.
Can I
just copy this?
Okay, you can copy it. I give you for 1 minute to finish this
okay,
one.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, I give everybody 1 minute to follow this code and run on your local to see the actual data. Yes, I have this on GitHub already. But yeah, I want people to follow the step by step first. Eventually, you will have it in Git and you share with everybody.
I mentioned about some of them.
Yes, so.
same. Yeah. SGPT. Yeah.
Again, because I think I missed out this line, the Gazelle HTTP client.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, okay. You need to Gazelle HTTP this one. No.
On slash, right?
Yes.
Anything else?
And okay. I'll come back because I don't remember. Symphony Commander.
The symphony part, right?
Yeah. Symphony, yes, I don't like this. Symphony components. Let's try it.
That's all right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Let's try to run it. Yeah. I think component, not components.
Sorry?
Yeah, you edit.
Run, right?
Yeah.
Okay, V1, right?
Yeah. No S. Component. Yeah, save it. You cannot run because this is class. You cannot run this one. Mm-hmm. Have you run the test?
The test is done.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
No, it's not running the test like this.
Mm-hmm.
You need to run by vendor, bin, PP unit. See, oh, no test, it's Q. No, you need to put this one. You didn't follow the folder structure.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Where should I put it in?
Okay.
I can't see, it's a bit too small.
Okay. That's why I said on the beginning, we need to yes, correct. What is composers as folder? How do you install the composer?
Just now I mentioned install. this one is installed in the server in the beginning.
Yeah, but you mean this? It cannot put the folder inside here.
If I run as root, this is a test server, it's okay.
No, I'm not sure if run it.
I can try running as root.
No, it's usually okay. Let can try. Can you run it?
Okay. I think to install in the vendor.
Yeah, yeah, it's okay. No. Why it's not?
But just now was okay, yeah, this one.
Why it's not output anything here?
But just now when you manage to run the unit first time.
I don't know why it's not output anything at all.
It's a unit thing, right?
Yeah.
See.
Try to run. Just.
Yeah. I try.
Yeah. Just run. Just run.
Okay.
Nothing happened.
This one was okay.
No, because this one is it's not detected anything.
Okay.
Yeah. You see? Because there's no class.
Oh.
Yeah.
See the error.
Yeah. Let me see this. Absos test is okay. Correct already.
It's not a clone, not from your.
Yeah.
No, the mouse
cannot. okay. a bit difficult to say.
Is it because the composer... Because just now initially when I download all the dependencies, right, it was on the... above the www. So I just move it into the www.
Yeah, can you try to run the composer in... No. No, it's okay. Yes. This is thin.
But if I do it above.
Hold on. When the. Can you make this part writable?
Okay.
Yeah. Try. Okay. So is this, can you run it?
Yep.
Okay, good. Anybody here have problem running it?
Oh. Can you show the run, how to run the test again, once again?
Okay, just vendor bin pip unit.
From this side.
Yeah.
PHP first?
vendor, the tab, yeah, bin, tab, PP unit, yeah, that's all. Just run it. Okay, like, let me check. You don't have a PHP exam cell.
Oh, is it wrong?
You need put on the root folder.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Just drag it to the root folder.
Sorry.
Yeah.
For the same level with this one.
Yes, okay, now you can try to run it. Plus 0 in. Okay.
9:13.
No comma, semicomma. Yeah. No, it's a source file. This is a test file. So it should be here. See, no comma. Okay, can run. Here, like 10. This one is arrow. Ten more, line 9. Can you go back? Can you go back? Is it wrong? Client. Okay, you need to use import the class. Give me. I go back to the. the. Use statement. Caso client, yes. Symphony component. DOM crawler. Yeah. Okay, let's run it. There you go. Yeah. Okay.
Just now I did it as root because when I installed, it keep asking me for the token.
Oh, okay.
So I just anyhow key in something, but.
No. You go to this one. Yeah. Go to this.
Uh huh.
Yes.
Uh huh.
And you copy the whole line. Open on the web browser,
uh-huh.
Even any web browser can do.
Okay.
And then if we ask you to log in and we display a token for you, you copy that token here.
Okay, but for the time being, can I just...
No, cannot. You have to it because for security reason.
I see.
Yeah. I think because many people here download from the git. Yes.
Yeah.
It's similar like reCAPTCHA.
When I did it just you are earlier, nobody
was. Yes, correct. What is this? Have you tried to install the Composer package? Yes. So Blender, Beam, sure.
Okay, yeah.
Is this the first test?
Huh?
This one? Okay, good. Can you follow?
I haven't finished anything.
Okay. You guys can follow it?
Yes.
Can run the test, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I cannot still run the test.
What's the... Okay. PP units is the source test. Okay. No test excuse. Excuse. So strange, right?
Okay.
Let me.
Do you want to sit?
No, it's okay. Test conference.
Because first it was showing errors. Then I updated. Then I.
So this conference is because things are fine. So this will be the test. Let's see, for my head. Quite strange.
Is testing.
No, dependency injection.
It's still dependency injection.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
But this one is the testing to make sure the code is running fine first.
Correct.
Yes. After that, I will tell you some more.
Yes,
we are going to it now.
Okay, sure.
I don't really understand why. Yes, so basically, you edit from here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Crawler. Add content.
You can see the line numbers. Show, right click and show.
Yeah, no. I'm using PPStorm, so it's 19. This one, I'm not sure. You have to install.
She was saying that it has to be installed from my.
How you install the Sequin? Can you run the Sequin installation again?
No, not yet. Okay. I think I haven't installed because it has to be in.
No, I installed the Sequin, not this one.
Sequin, no.
From here, right? How do you install it? I'm not sure. Previously, it's not here, so. Yeah, try to ask the lady because I'm not sure about this part. Sorry. Are you running? Good. Okay. Yes.
It doesn't find
convert not. Okay. This one, right?
Yeah.
Crawler Symphony Common Drum Corner. I think you put in the wrong one.
Oh.
Yeah, but you need to copy this line. Yes,
okay.
Over.
Where do you run the test? Under test conference or?
You can just run vendor.
No, you couldn't find the file. Yes.
Okay. CD. Okay. Vendor. Bin. Cannot.
Still cannot.
Yeah.
I managed to install everything already.
I think it's related to job permissions. Test conference. Yeah, I think it's related to the conference, so it cannot read it.
Which one? Vendor folder?
Yeah, can you go to the vendor folder? Try to run in a composer install again? Just remove the whole vendor
folder? Yeah,
that's how
I did it.
Oh, okay. So you run the composer install again,
yeah,
right?
Everything okay now and through everything.
Oh, okay, great.
Yeah. Mm. Is it a version of the unit tester?
No, it should be the same. See, it's still running.
Still running, right?
Yeah. So let's just see. Not getting anything. That's so strange.
You can see the error log.
No, this one is because you run PHP. Not sure about this. If Composer is running fine, I'm not sure. Can you have him on this one? I think I need to. He runs the PHP unit, but nothing happened at all.
This one, right?
But if you run a -- version, it displays something. So that means the library is still running.
Matthew did this log file, right?
No,
be, right?
No.
What's the log file? So they want that.
Because you run PHP and then it's. No, it's inside the vendor. Vendor bin. PHP. -- version. Try help. Yeah, it's displayed quite well. Yeah. P. Capital P. Nothing. It should display something.
Even if the code, there is something wrong with the code, you still display something, right?
Yeah. Is something wrong with the code?
Yeah. No,
I think this line is wrong. In array, so I have a name. Let me try to help you.
Escape?
Yeah.
Escape. So I use a nano.
Okay.
Okay. So it's because of that syntax?
I think so. Not that. Doesn't display anything at all, but you have some idea already, right? there is. I think we still have error in somewhere else, so with our source.
Fast.
Speaker client sedang client. It looks fine. This one wrong. Content. This one is not. I think there's something wrong with the code. So there's some error, a syntax. That's why it's
not. Just now, damn fast. Eh? I have no choice. I have to look at the next screen.
PHP timeline
is now like
not sure
anything. Get body, get contents.
Is it the verbose setting? Is that what you said?
No. No, it still displays something already. So I think it still has some error, but yeah. Everything looks fine here. But then I want to. Everything here, you copy for me, right?
This yeah, yeah. This one is cool.
Implements interface of this. Oops. We don't have any another file, right?
Hmm. But there is another one, there is two files inside. They're not even moving inside. In source, there are two files.
Yes.
Okay. Done.
Okay.
So it's the syntax?
Probably. I think it's a syntax issue. But if you run like this, it's not find any test. So maybe it's some permission issue. It cannot reach through this folder. So basically if you run put a specific file, it can run.
Okay.
Yeah. So leave it like this first.
I have to bring up this XML.
No need. Actually,
I just have to have the full path, lah. Absolute path, lah.
Yeah. See, it's still working.
So that means I need the full path, lah.
Yes, you need to put the path.
Okay.
Yeah. Just leave it for now first. Yeah. Yes. I think you haven't installed SSL.
Oh.
Yeah, PHP Open SSL. Try to search on how to install.
Okay, guys, let's continue. Okay, so we have a problem with our test when we lost internet connection, right? So what we're doing is we find a way to mock the connection. We don't actually send a request. So, okay. So basically, the next version, Iconis version 2, I will do a different with the previous version. So because in previous version, we need client, HTTP client, and also the DOM crawler. Now I put these two dependency in the constructor of the class. Yeah, sorry. Can see now? Okay. So basically, I put these two dependency in the constructor. So later, if I initiate the composer, initiate the object of this class, I can pass in the client and the crawler as a dependency. And before passing, I can mock the object, mock the HTTP client. So we don't have to send the actual request over internet at all. I will store these two objects as a protected property of the class so I can use later. Next, I will copy this code from version 1 to version 2 and I will modify it. So from here, we already have a client and crawler. We don't need to initiate the object inside this method anymore. Okay, so now we write the test for this one to make sure that this chain works. If I'm going too fast, you cannot follow, just feel free to interrupt me. So you guys have some time to follow it. Now what I'm doing is I create the test for this file for version 2.
Oh, shit.
Okay. So the structure of this test will look exactly like before. We have a conference object as a protected object. In order to reuse this, we have a setup to initiate the object of the class, and we have a test to actually run the test for our code. So I write the test first, and we will come up with the on the dependency later. So basically, what we want to test is to make sure that this name is inside the array, right? And here we see that the name is not defined. So we will get the result by calling the conference method. Okay, it's good for now. But the conference object is not initiated yet. We need to do it in the setup method. So in order to initiate the version 2, we need to pass in the client and the crawler object. Right. So basically what we're doing now is like we initiate the object outside of our class and pass in the object into the constructor. I guess this one will work, and I'm going to run the test now to see if it actually works or not. Yes, both tests, version 1 or version 2, are working. But let's see if I turn off the Wi-Fi, what happened? Both fail. You see, we have two errors here. So actually, the version 2 haven't made any change yet. What I'm doing now is I will mock the HTTP connection, so we don't rely on the internet anymore. So PHP unit give us the ability to mock object of a class by using this method, get mock builder, and we pass in the class name inside, and we want to mock only method request. Why is only method request? Because inside our code, this is the client only call a request. Okay. And this request will return a response object. So once I mock the request object, a request method like this, I need to this is just declaration that I want to mock, but I need to write the mock like explicitly. So client So I expected the request method will run once on the client object, and it will return the mock response object. Okay, but we haven't defined the mock response object yet, so we need to define it before this client. Here we have two methods need to be mocked. The first one is getBody, and the second one is getContents. Also, because I know that the response object need to have some data in the constructor, but I don't want to create the data of that, so I just ignore the construction. Yeah, the mocking is still running fine. Okay, since we define two methods to mock here, we need to declare the mock for these two methods. So here is the thing happen. We don't actually get the content of the page, but we know that we want to look for the H4 tag inside the object L1. So we will build a structure similar like this. So what I'm doing now is I build a structure, HTML structure. And I push this guy inside. So what this do is like, instead of running a actual request to a HTTP server, it will return a mock data, and our code will run on top of mock data. Okay, so since this client is a mock, it's better if we rename it as mock client instead of client. Okay, so now instead of passing into the constructor the actual client, we pass the mock client. So later when we call this method, this one will run this line. And this line, instead of actually connect to this HTML, it doesn't connect to anything at all. But it still return a data for the below code to be run. Yeah. The data is defined here. And the our code will run on top of this data. The crawler will try to find all the name inside the H4 tag inside the objects L1 class. I guess it will work. And let's try. You see, my Wi-Fi connection is still off. So what I guess is one test fail, one test pass. The first one will fail, the second one will pass. See? We have two tests, one error. Yeah. And you see all the error is coming from the first one because there's no connection. All is version 1. So if I enable the connection now, both tests will run and pass. So by moving the object inside the method body to the constructor, on the dependency to the constructor, we abstract the dependency and later we can inject it as whatever we want. It makes our code is loosely coupled and also is testable. Okay, but I think I need some more time to talk because we haven't stopped here yet. Like for example, this is a library, but when we go to a website, we type the URL on the website, the URL will go to the router, and the router will find what is controller and what is action for that one. And the controller will be run. The controller class will be initiated. And then it will pass the dependency into the controller. On another framework, it's done already. But we don't know what is happened behind. And where is the dependency is stored in the framework? So the one who stores the dependency in the framework, they call it dependency injection containers, or DI containers. Okay, from here, I don't actually write the routing, but I write a very simple script to dynamically map the request to the controller. I create a new file called index1. Index1 will use the version 1. And I will show you the two ways for inject the dependency into the controller. The first thing, I need to include the autoloader file. So all the file we download before will be used and can be used in our system.
Oh, sorry. I need to increase. Okay, what I'm going to do is I mean write some script so I can run something like this. PP index 1.pp and I put the conference 1. And action is speaker. Okay, I will run something like this later. And we need to get two arguments in order to run our controller. Just forget this one first. And the first argument is here, indicate the controller class. The second one is indicate the controller action. And once we get the controller class, we initiate the object of that controller and we call the action. Like this. So basically this is very simple mapping with our code to controller. But the thing is, like, we haven't write any controller class yet, right? We only write the conference class, which is library only. Now I'm starting write the controller to serve the request. I create a directory called controller. This one is namespace as well. Inside controller, my common bad practice is like I have an abstract class or I have a class interface. So all the there will be a if we have a common things between the class, we can put in the abstract class to share the code so we don't have to rewrite the code anymore. This abstract typo. This abstract class do nothing at all because we don't have any common, we don't have any share, or maybe we won't have, but just leave it like this because like our application is not so simple like this. For the long run, it will have a common code. I'm going to write the first controller. I call it conference once. And this one will extend the abstract controller we just created a few seconds ago. And inside here, we have a method called speakers. So here we have here and typo. Once we run this command, we try to map this request to our controller. So from here I'll put something like I return PP. For example, I put here FUBA is very common thing. Okay. And I expected I will get this string output to our my console. App controller conference one not found. Okay.
You see the error is like the glad is not found. Because our autoloader, this file is created after our autoloader file is created. So we need to recreate the autoloader file. In order to do that, we can run the composer install again. It will not download again, but it just recreate the autoloader file. It's just regenerating the autoloader files. It will include the controller one inside. And sorry? Okay. Yes, correct. My typo, sorry. Yeah, you see? The string is outputted, so the our routing is working. It's very simple routing. But here we want to get actually the name, right? So what do we do here? We initiate the conference. And we call the method list speaker. And then we expected we have a list of speaker as we've seen before. See, it's output here. So everything is working fine. But Ari says we don't want to have this. We don't want to have a construct the initiation of the object inside our code. So we wanted to move it to our constructor. So I will create a constructor here. I will create a protected property to store the constructor object. And from here, I just reuse it. Everything looks fine here. And do you think it's been run?
Sure.
Okay. I'll try. No, sorry. Because in order in our routing, we initiate the controller. And while initiating the controller, we don't pass any argument to the constructor. That's why argument one none given. So how you given it? One of the thing is like we automated the process, because a simple thing here in the index file, we can initiate the conference class here and put pass it in. But the thing is like, how about another controller? The argument is very dynamically. We cannot put everything here. So what we're doing is we use the reflection class to get all the arguments. And for each argument, we initiate the object for the argument and we pass it into the controller.
and create an array dependency to store all the dependency of this class. And for each parameter, and get the class name for it. And then I will initiate the object for this parameter, and I put it in the dependency array. Okay, and now we cannot use something like this anymore. We will use a reflection class to initiate the object for you. So this method will create a new instance with the arguments. The argument will pass into the constructor, and the argument is arrays, as we have here. So this one we try dynamically find out what is the parameter of the constructor for this class, and we automatically create the object for this class and automatically pass that parameter into the controller constructor. Yeah. I guess it worked here. Now it should work. Let's see. Yeah. So later, if we have more dependency, we can automatically inject into our controller. We can modifying our routing. But this one have limitation. The parameter class should not have any parameter as well. So if this one have another parameter, and the parameter require another parameter, we have a graph of dependencies. So there is some library already written for that. I'm not writing here, but if you want, I can recommend later. Just contact me and let you know. But this is a very simple way to demonstrate how you can automatically inject the dependency into our controller. And then from our controller, we can have fully do whatever we want. Okay. The last one is I want to introduce is a version 2 of this method. How we inject the controller as how we inject the dependency into our controller. I will run similar like this, but I will create another file called index2, another controller called conference2 with the same action. And what I'm doing is exactly almost the same. I copy this file first. Okay, from here I have a class name. I also have an action name already. This one I will use the DI container to inject the dependency into our controller. Okay, from here I register a conference, and I
this container will manage all the dependency, and we will get dependency dynamically in our code. Then from now, I will use the control and create a new version of controller. Exactly like before. Sorry. Not like before. Instead of I store the conference, store the dependency here, I will store the dependency containers inside here. Yeah. Sorry. Yes. And inside the action, I will try to get my dependency from the container. So this is the ID of the dependency. This ID have to match the ID we defined before inside here. And from here, we will use the dependency we just get. Okay, but let's run this one first to see if it works. I guess no, but I haven't created the object yet. Sorry. I need to create a controller object here. And the controller need to have a container as the parameter for constructor, so I pass a container here. Yeah. So let's run it. Okay. Here we come to another issue. The issue here is we create the conference object already, but our conference object requires two parameters, client and crawler. But client, we haven't passed a client or crawler to this class. So that's why this one not given, that's why it's true, it's error. Now we need to define the dependency and pass into the conference class. We can define inside here. We register a client. And we register the crawler. And now we add a argument to that. And we add a second argument for crawler. Now this one should work because own dependency is resolved. So this is how DI container work. We register all our dependency inside the container, and it's up to our controller to get whatever it need. So by doing like this, you don't have to specify the dependency in the constructor of the controller. Because who knows later if we have a new method, we need another dependency. And some controller have like 10 or 20 methods, and we have 10 or 20 dependency or even more. The constructor will be very big. So by using the container, the dependency of this controller is only the container. And each method, each action, it will get the dependency as it needed from the container. So by using like this, the code will look very cleaner. In some framework like Laravel or Symfony, for Laravel you can define a list of dependency inside the I'm not sure it's the provider, app service provider. And in Symfony you can define all of this dependency in the config.yaml as a service.yaml file. Yeah. I put it here because I just want to make it very simple for us to follow what is the magic inside the framework. How they map the URL to our controller. The basic thing is like this. We will have a more thing like authentication, logging, or something like catching or something like that. But basically it's like this. Yeah, I think I'm done for the dependency injection now. Anybody have questions? Okay, so to recap this one, when you write your code, think about the dependency. Think about how you organize your dependency. What is the best practice to inject the dependency into our class? You can do it automatically like what Laravel is doing. I like it somehow. But sometimes I prefer the Symfony way to have a container. So I just pass the container inside a controller. I can use whatever I want. I don't have to declare multiple dependency in my method. It have a pros and cons. It's up to you to decide. But remember, try to follow the dependency injection. Yeah. And one more thing you can improve from here is like instead of depends on concrete class, you can depend on interface. Yeah. But the thing is like, it's not easy to initiate the object for interface here because you cannot create an object for interface. There are a way to do that by you can do an alias in some, like you map, like for example, for this round, you map the conference interface with a concrete class for version 1 or version 2. It's up to you. Decide that. But it's a bit complex, so I don't want to introduce it here. Yeah. And by using the dependency, as you can see, right, by using the dependency injection, we can easily to swap the object. We can easily to test it. And we by making the our class decoupling to each other, we can easily to extend it, add more feature, and we replace, like for example, instead of use, like for, you don't have to worry about if you use a MySQL or Mongo or PostgreSQL DB, you just write a abstract a class for that or interface for that first, and we inject it later. So do think about the dependency injection while you are before you start writing your code. Yeah. So thank you for listening. Yeah.
Thank you.